Hello there, welcome to Coffee Gangs. Another beautiful evening out here, and of course it's a Saturday. Most of us would have gone for Owambe, and it's now time to sit and relax with the ladies. We're going to talk about something that affects our society, our community, and we cannot shy away from it. And of course they say the younger generation makes the future, so if you don't take care of our future today, what happens to our country itself? We are looking at Nigeria now. Well, it's great to be here. My name is Bola of Himo School, and of course I'm not alone on this table of coffee. I'm with the ladies. Good to have you here. We have Patricia Yolade here too.
Thank
Good to have you. Yeah, I even like your orange top.
Hey,
it's looking nice and busy and swaggish. Yes, swaggilicious, right? Okay, ladies, let's table this. This Child Right Act, it's one thing that has been domesticated in some states, but then in some states it's still like a cliche, you know. If you look at the northern part of the country, for instance, they give out children in marriage as very early age. But, you know, let's even come down to Oyo, where we see a lot of street kids, we see a lot of them selling things. And let's also remember that the governor, when he came into office, actually said that 3,000 naira will not be paid. You know, you can go to school freely, but you still have some of these kids selling on the streets. The question I keep asking myself is that, is it that the parents do not want them to be responsible to go to school, or the parents are too lazy to cater for their kids? At least if you're going to school free, the parents should be able to cater for their meal. At least go and whatever you want to go and hawk for these kids, pending when they'll come back from school. It cannot cost you 1 billion naira to feed three children, because I've seen instances of three families, as in three children on the street at the same time from the same mother and the same father. And if you ask them, you say, why are you not in school? They'll say, my parents, they don't have money to send me to school, so they send them on the street to beg or even hawk. So I keep wondering that, what is our society degenerating into? Is it just about passing laws now? There are a lot of laws, you know, in the country that frowns at, you know, child labor and the rest, even international treaties. And Nigeria is actually signatory to all these treaties, but still you see some of these young ones on the street cleaning. In fact, sometimes I always pray that cars, moving vehicle, will not knock them down. They'll be at your screen and wanting to clean the screen at all costs, and you're like, wait, don't run. Exactly. And you keep wondering that these are people who were given birth to by parents. What is really happening to our morals?
I would say it's the parents, actually.
Okay.
They are the ones to blame, because these kids are still quite young, most of them. They are still young. We can say they don't know their right from their left. But parents, maybe it's because of the benefits they seem to be getting from.
But what kind of benefits?
The work that those children are doing, they get some money from it. How much do the children actually want to spend themselves? It's the parents spending it, because before it was okay, and the money, it's expensive. Even that tiny amount of money was expensive. Okay, now the money is not there anymore, yet we still have children out of school. It just seems like they don't see the importance of education. And some of them even do.
I would like to put in some few points here. The thing is, in this country we have the grassroots and we have the people here, high up here.
The rich.
We have the governors, we can't call them the grassroots. And then they get into office, they pass these laws and say, okay, school is free. Who are you giving the school free to? Are they not the grassroots? Do they even have this information that school is free? Those children running on the streets, go out and do a serious studies on them. You find out that they don't even know school is free. Their parents don't even know school is free.
So what are the local government chairmen doing?
The local government chairmen are just there for the politics. My advice to governors, to government, is that when you're passing out this law, have agents that goes out to this grassroots. Connect with the local government chairman.
And these agents will collect money. Patricia, don't collect money.
From the government, yes. That is why we pay tax. All these things should be added. Because if you're giving free school to people that don't even know it is free, that is not free. Because you keep having the same problem over and over again. If you like, come to the court.
Is it that they don't know?
Some of them,
or the parents
don't
know? Because I've seen instances where I even told one at Mokola.
Which
school is free? What are you doing?
Some
of them do truth. Can afford to pay cost.
Another thing we should ask again is, are the books free? Because having your school fees free is different from books. You understand?
But government cannot do everything. Actually,
a different problem entirely.
Government cannot
get your kid into school. At least, even if I'm not saying that's the ideal situation.
Yes.
Even if you don't have access to books or something, you are in school listening to whatever your teacher.
Exactly, and you're jotting.
But if you don't have access to the right materials, then some kids will do better than some kids. Then why are you punishing these children, taking them to school when you know they don't have access to the right materials? That's the problem we have in Nigerian school these days.
But does he
you
explain?
See people going to school and then they don't have access to the right materials. Thank God for internet, thank God for phones, thank God for everything. But then when we're going to school, we don't have access to so many materials.
But you were going
but
to
you
library.
Went to school. But you
were going to library.
I was going to library because I was allowed to go to school, because my parents could afford it, because my parents could buy exercise book for me and see no problem with it. Let me tell you, these people, they think these grassroots people, the way they think, I want to buy exercise book for 20 naira.
Patricia,
this 20 naira can buy a pot for us to eat in.
But let's look at it this way.
That's just the.
But let's look at it this way.
That is what I'm saying, that if you send agents out to make these people to change their orientation, nobody's educating them. Nobody's making them
see.
Let
me
realize this.
Nobody
will do it. Until you start arresting parents that don't put their children
in.
If
you arrest me, see, that doesn't solve the problem. You arrest me today, I see you as a wicked person because my mentality has not changed.
Wait, what I just want to ask is that why would you give birth to children you can't take care of? Why do you suffer them?
The truth is, we don't control what husband and wife do inside the room. The ones we can control, let us control it.
But they can go as far as going on the street and dragging people down to give them money at all costs.
If all these politicians, they start their campaign and all that, they go to the grassroots. So when it comes to campaigning for this, why don't they go to the grassroots? Why don't they go to their houses to meet them and start delivering all these things to them? Let's be realistic here. When they start their campaign for vote for me, vote, they can even enter where they sell corn, Bolly. Sit down there. So now that they are
believes rather than spend this 15 naira on education, let me buy vegetables. Even if you campaign and start singing it in the person's ears, that person will still
the mentality.
Let me tell you the truth. These people at the grassroots, their mentality, yes, is very difficult to change. But let me tell you the truth. By the time you come down to their level, you make them understand. When they see a governor sitting with you and telling you that your child education is free, I don't think any sane person.
Let's now paint this picture of Shein Lamaje. Yoruba will say, is that what we will eat? Telling my child that has been bringing in 100 naira, 200 naira for me, and now a governor is not coming to tell her or him that you have to send this child to school. They see their children as breadwinner. And of course, like Wura said, I feel personally that it should be criminalized.
Yes.
If you allow your kids go on the street, you must be responsible for them. For you giving birth to these kids, you have to show responsibility as a parent. You cannot afford to
but
say,
don't forget that there are some children that are orphans. There are some parents that are blind. There are some that are disabled.
And they will use their kids to beg on the street.
Where will you now put those ones? When the government don't even have
my
any,
question is, are they no relatives? Do they come down from the moon?
Is it every relative that is nice?
Is it
every relative that will want to take responsibility of you get? Sometimes they don't care.
What if there were no
and
children?
And then they're left with this, their parents, their aged parents, or these kids are orphaned, nobody's taking care of them. Maybe their mom died 3 years ago, their dad died 2 months ago, nobody cares. The house rent is expired, they just push the children outside and they're sleeping on the street and they're saying, okay, let's look for what to do. And then you see them on the street. In that case, who are you going to arrest?
I don't believe in child labor. But even if you
I understand what you're saying.
I don't support child labor. But if you see some of these kids, even when like a parent who is a voluntary person who wants to take them in, these children will not be willing to stay under a roof, under a clean condition. They have a mentality which their parents have imbued in them right from when they are young, that you beg to survive. So it's very difficult to take away that habit. Put them in a clean house. In fact, create a condition where there's AC, there's books, there's everything. But their mindset have been eroded with
some
bad principles. And go out and beg.
What?
So how do you now tame these children now? It starts from the home. Because as a parent who is giving birth, when you're sleeping with a man, you know know that, of course, you get pregnant, you will give birth. And if you look at family planning, in fact, they make it, you don't have to pay for family planning. They still go to these hospitals and give birth. And you see these nurses telling them, please, after 6 weeks, after so time, come for family planning. Some of them will not go. Some of them will say cultural factor. Some of them will say, my husband does not like it. You know, instances like that gives room for them to start giving birth. Then the next thing is, okay, we can't feed ourselves. The next thing is, you will now still use the same children who came into the world for different purposes to push them to survive.
But sometimes does it really make sense? I feel sometimes follow-up needs to be made. When it comes to...
By who now?
By the government.
By the government. Okay.
There should be follow-up. You say you know these people has cultural issue. You know, even when you tell them to come, they don't come back.
They still won't come.
Follow up. Let me give you an instance of marketing. You want to market a product. You call the person. Oh, I don't want. You call the person again. Oh, I don't. We go on. We keep calling the person until we are able to convince this person. But in this country, is I don't care. Ah, she has said she doesn't want. Just let her be. Forgetting that at the end of the day, it still backfires on the society. So allowing these people go like, ah, she said she doesn't want to, let's leave her alone. It will still backfire on the government. And we will still have many children roaming the streets. And,
you know, when you look at all of this issue, Patricia, you were actually talking about the fact that government needs to be very responsible. I'm not saying that it's not right for government to be responsible. But what I indeed said, criminalizing it will make people sit up. Because it's like parents, some parents have seen it as a way of levity.
They are.
I can do it and
until
go away with it.
Until they know that they are at risk of going to jail if they don't do the needful. That's when people will start doing it. That's when people would know. They would spread the news. And nobody would want to do
it. But really, how does it really feel? Like now as a mother, you just sit down. Your 5-year-old will now come and meet you. Mommy, I've sold 100 naira today. And you have the conscience to collect that money. Like, it's so embarrassing.
Since they're still doing it, I'll say it feels good to them. It feels good.
To them, the child is helping. After all, they said, there's an adage that they said, these children that will take care of the parents. So they catch them young. They are trying to take care of their parents while they are saying, it's 100% wrong.
Very.
It's 100% wrong to have your child on the street. No matter the age, a child is a child. You should allow that child to enjoy their childhood. But the question still boils down to, what is our government doing about it? Do they even have data of these kids? Do they even have the names of the kids they've taken off the streets? Is anybody having a record of this? There's nothing. So if this child goes back to the street, because sometimes they go to school and we all know we are all human beings, and they might meet a teacher they don't really like that treats them anyhow, matches them anyhow, and they go back to the street. Nobody's even following up. There's no social...
Even if you look at the society today, our value system has really depreciated.
Yeah.
If you look at those who have risen up today, as in rich, quote and unquote, handling big offices in Nigeria, they are not the kind of silver spoon or butter and bread kind of children when they were growing up. In fact, some of them suffered a lot. We could have some of them saying that they never wore shoes when they were going to school, but they survived. And some of them ate eba all through their life, and they did not die. They had a parent catering for them.
But don't forget, but out of the 100 that never wore shoes, how many survived? That is the question.
At least we have a test case of people who survived. But these days, you see multitude of children on the streets.
As a parent, or your state, for instance, your child, to give your child that chance.
Exactly.
A chance to at least try to make something of himself. Not you defining what the child should be in life. And I'm not talking about career. But you not letting the child go to school, see ease or her potential. You're already labeling the child, putting in child. That child will remain in the grassroots level, like we said. So something like that, it's not fair.
It's actually not fair, Wura. Because most time, even if you pass across, let's take Mokola for instance. Very young girls, very young boys. And they are vibrant, they are intelligent. For them to be, some of them can talk for complete 20 minutes, begging you with all sorts. Then you keep wondering in your mind, if you're this good, if you have this oratory spirit, then why are you on the streets? They should channel their energy well.
Let's also not forget about some children that are very, how do I put it, are very naughty. They have this, they have challenges with their parents, not because the parents is punishing them or the parents doesn't want them to go to school, but you just leave home. And then you go to the parents, parents say, I'm tired. I've been looking for this child since last year. They will bring the child home, the child will. There's something the Yorubas call them. those ones that just, especially the boys, they just roam around the street, you just see them. So sometimes it's not 100%
the parents'
fault.
Well, that's where the government should come
in. So we are not all perfect. A child like that that you keep, you will not lock up your child will not be in prison inside your own home. So sometimes it's not the parents'
But really, there are better ways for parents to handle such kids, because you cannot have five kids, for instance, and not have one that will be a little bit dissenting from your principles. Mm-hmm. You might have principle. In fact, you might be a soldier and say, in my house, don't do blah, blah, blah. And you still have one that will want to dissent.
That wants to be different.
Then you must pay key attention to that child. There's something unique about that child. And that's the more reason you can. Because sometimes when they realize that this child is dissenting, what the parent does is that, Shebi is the only one. Shebi, I have plenty one. Mm-hmm. And let him just dissent.
But the fact is that
you need to pay attention to that
parents,
one because it could damage this future
parents
of the
still
family.
The same parents that in Nigeria here, if you have just one person having the income coming in, is not easy.
Of
this,
course,
these parents are parents that the father goes out in the morning, the mom goes to the market, and they expect the student to be in school, and this child goes out of school, and then doesn't attend school. Before you know, a year has gone by. The mother doesn't even know that the child is not going to school, because she's busy trying to make
and
sure...
And that's a message for parents!
Make sure they feed. Make sure they feed. See, sometimes I don't blame the parents, because they're trying to help this child. And in school, the teachers are supposed to concentrate and take care of this child. And say, okay, so this and so person did not come to school today. Let me even inform the parents. They don't care. Because they feel, the mom...
But you were saying something. I was thinking that that's actually a message for parents. You can't be so occupied with whatever you're doing without actually checking on your kids. For instance, what are these children up to? Have I seen them today? Some parents even go as far as getting them a GSM, not the ones they can browse with. Well, at least they could monitor them. When are you home?
That's
what
did
you
do today? Ones. That's for the ones that can afford it.
Okay.
if you save, as a parent who loves your children, if you save, how much do they sell all this palace? Let me not mention it, so I won't promote now. But some are very cheap. That you could communicate, maybe your job
to
is very tasking.
Cheap to some people.
Oh, really? But how long will it take for you to save? How long will it, even if you save peanuts? I think it has to do with if you're a parent, you must be hardworking beyond the government. Because how many things must the government pay attention to? Government cannot come and feed you in your home. Okay. In fact, the government who has family, he's actually
that's
wanting to send outside the country.
Give back to the children that
you can't
take
off.
That so you want to work yourself to the bone.
Also why the government needs to create more agencies, work more with the NGOs, invest in the NGO, fund these NGOs, make them realize, okay, these are the areas we need you. We don't want these children becoming users. Because let's be honest here, these kids we are talking about on Namokala Bridge, by the time they are 15, 16, they will start raping girls.
Which is terrible.
The money they're getting from people will not be enough.
It will be enough.
So they would have to.
And some of them will take to drugs
too. You will see some. Yeah, some of them, before you know, they'll start taking weed. They'll start taking the codeine and
the society will suffer for it.
Yeah, we're not even talking about going insane. Some of them, their brain will not be able to carry it. They will go insane. They will become mad. That's another life.
Innocent people.
So a lot of things is a combined effort. The parents and the government, but at the same time, there's supposed to be something down to put it down to let these parents understand that this is what it is. This is the way they go out to campaign and say, okay,
let me even talk about the NGOs that you mentioned. How many of these NGOs are even truthful? Some of them go after international funds. Did you not come to the society to replicate all the things they said they would do?
There should be checks and balances.
Where does the government come in?
There should be checks and balances.
Who monitors them?
There should be checks and balances.
If you're
registered under the government as an NGO, that okay, the government is going to fund you, this is your role. The government should have people that do checks and balances. You cannot just let them have the veto power to do whatever they want because they're NGOs.
That's
no.
Right.
So once you are funding them, there should be checks and balances.
We hope that the checks and balances will work, because it's not even working in other areas. Hopefully our NGOs, who sometimes could even pay their way through, they can cut corners and have their way through. But I think as a matter of fact, as a parent, you must be responsible. If you know that you want to go into childbearing, there are a lot of things you could put into factor. You could put into fact here that, like, okay, in the next 2 years, I'll be prepared to actually have a child. In the next 1 year, I could do this. In fact, the world is made easier. Why do you have to suffer yourself? They say ignorance is a disease, and it's not an excuse. A lot of parents know. That's why I say that some of them are even guilty of some of these offenses. Exactly. Because you're aware that when you do this, you're no longer a child. When you're married, when you do this and that, it culminates, it comes back to a child. You're going to give birth to a child. Then that child, you owe that child a responsibility to give that child the best. Then at the end of the day, you benefit from it. This child does not become a rogue. They'll come one day and say, "Mommy, how much do you have?" and put a gun to your head. Then that's when you now know the reality that you've not really trained the child well. And I don't think you need billions of naira to actually train a child. You could cut your coat according to your size. In fact, I know of some parents who sold their wrapper, who actually sold their expensive things to push their kids to be better in life.
Those are people that are willing to sell their wrapper. If you're talking of parents, somebody gave birth to that parents. What's that parents' background? That's what you should.
But you should learn too, because
what's the parents' background.
Your body even
where
said,
are they coming from? What kind of mentality do they have? Were they under the bridge and someone got them pregnant and put them in the house?
My goodness.
So those are the questions you should ask. So me being under the bridge at the age of 15 and one conductor or one bus driver slept with me, impregnated me, and I gave birth, and my child at the age of 6-7 is under the bridge, I won't find any
further.
That's the way I found my livelihood. Now look at me now. I'm in my husband's house. So you gotta take care of yourself. So those are the things we need to change.
But I think the mentality to things needs to change.
Yes, it needs to change. I need to change the mentality. It's not the mama boss that is sitting beside her that both of them are at the same level. It's not mama boss that will change that.
So somebody has to go there to rotate them.
That's what I'm saying. The government has to create an agency for these people. Take people out to educate this. It might not be for the whole 4 years they're going to be in six. If you do this for 1 year or 2 years, you will see changes. Why? You will not get everybody. Everybody must not follow.
But another thing,
bad
okay,
for these things to be used together alongside while people are being orientated on the right ways and the right things, if they still continue after a particular time that you're sure that okay, a lot of people know about this
about
thing, if they still continue, then you can start punishing people.
I think the thing is that you don't even know when they would dissent from the principles. Now the thing is, I keep wondering, don't they go to churches, don't they go to mosques, they go to religious organizations where they talk about all of these things? Do they keep a deaf ear? Because
are you sure the religious organization is talking about this?
They do.
Are you
in fact,
sure?
At society level, they do.
We churches. We are talking more about tithes. We are living all this.
Oh my God, that's not even going to that.
We are talking about tithes and how God will bless
us. But I know, as a matter of fact, that religious organizations have always tried. In fact, if you go to some of these Orthodox churches, they do that a lot. And most of our parents have passed through the Orthodox Church, somehow, one way or the other.
Let's not forget
even the new generation churches that we have today. We have society levels who educate women, who talk to women. But do you still find it funny that some of them don't even listen? Some of them are not even willing because it's an habitual thing. But what gives?
That's why we shouldn't leave it up to those people. That's why we have to have people that know actually what they are doing. They know what to tell them. The experts, the right people. Like
the right
you said,
people.
Yes.
Psychologists.
Exactly.
Employ psychologists to talk
to these
people.
The
proper way, yes.
To not just leave it to random people to just start saying whatever they want.
Because that explains many of these children you see on the streets in Ibadan. Because I keep wondering. In fact, there was a young guy. He was begging and he was begging. At the point, I had to sound like, what is this? I was supposed to be in school. Hey, Joe, mo follow mba ben, mo lo. Like, she was begging me with all the appeal and using God's name that, like, the parents do not have money to send him to school. I said, where are his parents? They are home.
Really?
So I was not thinking in my head. So you now go on the streets and beg for
money.
And in
the
evening, you now give them money. How about?
Well, sometimes these kids might even be lying.
That's another thing.
These kids,
another thing.
Like, just to make you have pity on them and say,
exactly.
Oh, so they left you to come and beg. So we have to be very careful in cases like this.
Oh my goodness.
That child, just tell that child,
Let's go to your home. He will run away.
So sometimes they might even be lying. So all these things has to do with combined efforts.
Exactly.
You talk to the children. And don't forget, some of those children under the street, it's not just because it's poverty. Some of them, they are being molested. They left home.
So like those people who keep their kids with aunties, uncles, even for housemates.
Some of them even stay with their parents and their father is sleeping with them.
My God.
So most of those kids you see under the bridge, don't just think, oh, this one, they don't want to go to school, it's poverty. Those kids are going through a lot. Maybe their uncle or their auntie or a landlord or somebody.
He's molesting them and they're not talking
and
out.
And not just for female children alone, male children.
Of course, it cuts across. It does.
Sometimes it's not just because they are poor or because they can't afford to go to school. These kids, and if they tell their mother, oh, daddy touched me, my husband, they'll start beating that child.
Well, it's so painful that we have to run up. But I think that is a big message for parents, caregivers, and also stakeholders in the sector of encouraging young children to go back to school, to actually key into some of these treaties that we've signed internationally and ensure that children go to school. It's very important. Leaving them on the streets, they are vulnerable to so many ill vices. And we want to see our society cleaned off of children who are not in school, children who are impoverished, children who beg, you know. And we want to see a society much more clean, much more responsible, and of course responsible parents who are taken into family planning. It's not going to hurt. At least it will help you space your child and take care of them appropriately. Well, from here, it's a bye. My name is Bola Bofimo School. Do you have a pleasant evening?
My name is Pat Oyelade. Nice being here.
We're happy you came. And we're Ola Ola Kombi. Bye. Join us next week. Bye bye.